Hello friends, in this lecture today we will see how to solve system of equations using Crout's LU decomposition method. Then we will see where this LU decomposition method fails, means where we cannot apply LU decomposition to solve system of equations. And finally we will see the recursive formula to get the coefficient of or the entries of lower triangular and upper triangular matrices of LU decomposition method for Crout's LU decomposition method and Doolittle LU decomposition methods. Okay, so now starts with the problem. So the problem is x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 1, first equation. Second equation is 4x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 equal to 6. Third equation is 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 3x3 equal to 4. Now we will solve it through Crout decomposition method. In Crout decomposition method, it is one kind of LU decomposition method. So what to do? We have to write the coefficient matrix, that is A. I am writing the coefficient matrix, that is first row is 1, 1, 1. Then second is 4, 3, minus 1. Third is 3, 5, 3. Now this equation I have to decompose into lower triangular and upper triangular matrix in such a way that the diagonal entries of the upper triangular matrix is 1. So we have to write this, then we have to multiply. If we multiply, then what will happen? We will get the matrix, and that matrix will be equal to A. So now if we multiply, so how will multiply? First row will be first column, so first entry L11, first row second column, this L11 U12, first row third column, that is L11 U13. Okay, similarly second row with first column, second row with second column, second row with third column, then we will get this second row of the matrix, similarly third row. So after that, what to do? The main task is find out the Lij value and Uij values, these unknown values. Okay, once we find the these coefficients or these entries, the process will be little easy. Okay, so now how to find? Now each element of this matrix we have to equate with each element of this A matrix, means corresponding A matrix. This means L11 will be equal to 1, then L11 we got 1, then first column second row is 2 1, L21 that is 4, so it will be 4. Similarly L31 will be 3. Now similarly second row, how to calculate second row? Second row means this, first row. First row means these values. So this U12 and U13. So U12 is here and U13 is here. So from this and this we will find. So if we see, this element will be what? 1. So L11, U12 is 1. So what will happen? L11 we know 1. So U12 will be 1 by 1. So it will be 1. Similarly, we have to find U13 is what? U13 is 1 divided by L11, that is 1. That way we can get. So we got 5 values. Now again we have to use these 5 values, and then we have to find the other values. Okay, other unknown values. So similarly second column, how to calculate? Second column is this column. So L22. So how to calculate L22? L22 is here in A22. This is A22, so 3 equal to this. So if I put all the previous value where it is involved, some value L21 and this U12, then after equating we will get L22, that is minus 1. In similar fashion, if we equate this value with minus 1, we will get L32 as 2. This element if we equate with 5, then we will get L32 is 2. Then similar way, second row means this element. So U23 we can calculate from this element. If we equate with minus 1, we will get U23 is 5. Similarly L33 will be minus 10. Now after getting these things, we can write this equation as L equal to what? L11, so 1, this is 4, this is 3, so 0 0 Then L22, so L22 is minus 1. Then L32, it will be 2. So this will be 0, this will be minus 10. Okay. Similarly, what is U matrix? U matrix is this, nothing but 1, and this U12. So 1, 1, 0, 1, U23. So U23 is 5. Similarly, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now, what is the procedure? The procedure is, this system is what? I can write it as Ax equal to this B. If I write B, where B equal to 1, 6, 4, this vector. So what we got? We got A in terms of L and U. So we will replace that. A equal to L U X equal to B. Okay. Now this U X will represent in other name, that is U X equal to Z. If we change, so this will be L Z equal to B. Okay. Now from this L Z equal to B, we have to find Z. Now L is what? This. So this into Z. Now I am writing Z equal to some Z1, Z2, Z3 column vector. Okay. And B, we know B is 1, 6, 4. This column vector. Now we'll write and equate. If you write and equate, it will be what? 1, 0, 0, 4, minus 1, 0, 3, 2, minus 10. Okay, this matrix into is Z1, Z2, Z3. Okay, this equal to 1, 6, 4. Now, how to do? If you see, so substitution method you can find. So, first row it is 1, 0, 0. So, Z1 will be 1, then Z1 will be 1, then Z2. 4 Z1 minus Z2, okay, equal to 6. So Z will be what? Minus 2, okay, or this will be Z2. So finally, we'll get Z3 equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, now what to do? We know Z1, Z2, Z3 value. Now we'll use this Z1, Z2, Z3 value here in this equation, okay, in this equation star. So what will happen? This Z equal to UX, okay? U we know, U is this. So 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 5, 0, 0, 1, okay? Now we have to apply this Z, but for that we need X1, X2, X3. So in this equation, if we put Z, so then we'll find what? We'll find x1, x2, x3. So Z will be what? We know 1 minus 2 minus 1 by 2. Okay. So here the simple step is there. So again, you have to substitute back substitution method. So 1, x3 will be minus 1 by 2. x3 will be minus 1 by 2 that we got from this. Now putting this again, we'll get x2. So x2 will be 1 by 2. If we put the value and solve, then finally if we put and solve, then x1 will be 1. So this is our desired solution. Okay, we will see that how to find these coefficients. Okay, L11, L21, L31, U12, U13, like Lij and Uij, because this part is important. If it is a big matrix, okay, then how to find? We'll have complex computation. In that situation, we have to generate one recursive formula so that we can easily find. So next we will see how to find the recursive formula for these two methods, Crout's method and Doolittle's LU decomposition method. First we will see Doolittle's method, means where the Doolittle method fails. Then we will find the recursive formula for getting these coefficients or getting these elements. Okay. So, in general, a system of equation is written as Ax equal to B. Then if I apply Doolittle's method, it will be LU into X, where L is this matrix and U is this matrix, equal to B. That I can write it as X equal to LU, that inverse into B, and this will be what? B inverse L inverse, okay, sorry, this is U inverse, L inverse into B. Now the thing is that if we get, okay, like any diagonal entries of this upper triangular matrix as 0, then this system fails. Okay, that I can write it as, if uii equal to 0, then Doolittle method fails. Okay, we cannot apply. Okay, so if it is n by n system, then we'll have n diagonal entries, and we have to see that this I can write it as for some i, okay, for some I, if uii equal to 0, it is failed. If it is not zero for all the diagonal entries, then we can apply. Okay, now we will see the recursive formula to find out the Lij value and what Uij value, and A entries of A we can write it as Aij. Okay, so first we will see how to find Lij. Okay, Lij entries, these entries. Okay, now if you see here the first column, okay, how to find first column, second entry is L21. How to find L21? L21 equal to what? A21 divided by U11. Okay, then L31 equal to A31 divided by U11. So in such a way that we have to find. Okay, then we will see Uij. So Uij, how to find? If you see, so A11 is U11, A12 is U12, A13 is U13. In such a way that the first row will be first row of A. So from that we can find Uij. So the formula is, if we generalize this concept and if you use these equations also, then Uij will be Aij minus summation of L I K, okay, U K J, okay, where K from 1 to J minus I. Similarly, L I J is A I J minus summation of L I K U K J, K from 1 to that I minus 1 divided by U I I, where I greater than J, and here J is greater than equal to I. Okay. So similarly, Crout's method, same way I have to proceed. So I have to write the equation in same way, and we will get this form, and here we can see that the diagonal entries of Lii, okay, here Lii, okay, this equal to 0 for some I, then it fails. Okay, that means we cannot apply Crout's method. Now we will see how to find Lij and Uij. Okay, so Lij is what? You can see first column L11, L21, L31. So it is just like reverse of Doolittle's method. So Lij will be Aij minus, okay, summation of K equal to 1 to I minus 1, okay, Lik UKJ. Okay, so this one, okay, for what? For I is greater than equal to J. Okay, and how to find Uij? So Uij is nothing but Aij, okay, minus summation of Lik UKJ from K equal to 1 to J minus 1, okay, this divided by what? Lii. Here J, okay, greater than I. So this is all about the recursive formula for Doolittle and Crout's method.